Hello?
Amen.
Okay. It's now time for the sermon. I ask that everyone please stand as we welcome our Reverend, Reverend Lambo. Amen.
Amen.
We open our hearts of prayer. Father Almighty, we thank you, O Lord, for the privilege you give us today to be counted among those to approach your throne of grace, to be fed with your words. We thank you, O Lord, for your loving kindness, for making known to us the misery of the kingdom of heaven that were denied to many religious leaders and the Jews. As you approach your throne, Father Almighty, we beseech you, O Lord, to consecrate your message. Anoint the tongue, Father, that will deliver it. Open our hearts, Father, consecrate our hearts. We beseech thee, Father, to give us wisdom and increase our understanding to be able to know you more and do your will. Do not let us be hearers alone, Father, but dwellers of thy word. And let each word that is going to be sown this morning find fertile ground in our heart. We beseech thee, O Lord, to turn us around, creating us a new heart, and let us live in Christ and not with Christ.
Amen.
And never let our lives be the same again. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, Father, we pray.
Amen.
Please be seated. And that brings us to the theme of this morning's message: are you a born-again Christian? Are you a born-again Christian? The Lord left us with a promise that he will send a comforter who will live with us and teach us and explain to us all the things that he, the Master, has taught us, and in addition, we shall be bold to witness unto him from Jerusalem to the uttermost parts of the world. And this comforter is the Holy Spirit, which some Christian religion organizations present as later rain, according to Prophet Joel in chapter 2, verse 28 to 29. God revealed to him all that will happen before the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. And he reads, "And it shall come to pass afterward, that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams, your young men shall see visions, and also upon the servants and upon the handmaids in those days will I pour out my spirit." All denominational churches, they celebrate that great day when that precious gift promise by the Lord was received, which we call the day of Pentecost. And that was 40 days after the Lord resurrected from the dead. An account of that great day was recorded in Acts of Apostles, chapter 1, verses 1 to 5. It says, "The former treaties have I made, O Theophilus, of all that Jesus began both to do and teach, until the day in which he was taken up. After that, he, through the Holy Ghost, has given commandment unto the apostles whom he had chosen, to whom also he showed himself alive after his passion by many infallible proofs, being seen of them 40 days, and speaking of the things pertaining to the kingdom of God, and being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which said, ye have heard of me. For John truly baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence. When the Holy Spirit had descended upon them, they were all speaking in different tongues, meaning in all languages of the world, and not in the tongues you are familiar hearing in our churches today. And that was why all the Jews that were based in all parts of the world could hear the apostles speaking in the native languages of their own individual countries, who had come to Jerusalem for the feast of the Passover, about Jesus the Messiah. In Acts of Apostles 2:1-8, we read, and when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven, as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire, and it sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost, and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. And there were dwelling at Jerusalem Jews, devout men, out of every nation under heaven. Now when this was noised abroad, the multitudes came together, and were confounded, because that every man heard them speak in his own language. And they were all amazed and marveled, saying one to another, behold, are not all these which speak Galileans? And how hear we every man in our own tongue, wherein we were born, Parthians, and Medes, Elamites, and the dwellers in Macedonia, and in Judea, and in Cappadocia, in Pontus, in Asia, in Phrygia, in Pamphylia, in Egypt, and in all parts of Libya, about Cyrene and strangers of Rome, Jews and proselytes, Greeks and Arabians, we do hear them speak in our own tongues the wonderful works of God. Hallelujah! And they were all amazed, and we are in doubt, saying one to another, what does this mean? What does this mean? From that day, after Apostle Peter has confessed Jesus Christ as the Messiah, all the Jews who believed carried the good news back to their various countries, and thus marking the beginning of the spread of gospel, from which we are beneficiaries today, sharing that great gifts for those who believed and are living in Jesus Christ. You can be a Christian, but not all Christians are born again Christians. How then do you become a born again Christian? Many Christians today who have accepted Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior and believe that he died for us and he rose from the dead and being baptized are deemed to be saved and should not need to be baptized again. Many people are baptized, of course, but how many who call themselves Christians really understand what it means to be a follower of Jesus Christ? In other words, living in Christ. Christianity is not a modification of our old faith and our old life or our old ways of thinking and relating with others. It is not a gift for us on us to wear it like a gown. And when needed, and conveniently remove it and hang it in the closet, whenever it suits our convenience, to enable us to satisfy our worldly pursuits of freedom. If you have received the gift of the Holy Spirit, like most of us have, and you are still living in your old Adamic ways, your baptism will not save you. Nicodemus was told by the Lord in John 3:5-6. Jesus answered,